Hi everyone, as many of you already know, a few days ago Midjourney shared their new version, version number 5. This is not the final version by just an alpha test, but I'm so excited already to have a look at it and start playing with it. They've used different neural network architectures with respect to previous versions, and they use new aesthetic techniques. So the expectation is really, really high. Again, this is not the final version, so we should expect a lot of modifications during the next months before the final version is released. So what I wanna do today, I just wanna do a simple comparison using the same prompt between version 4 and version 5. I wanna see the improvements of version 5, and I also wanna see what has not improved. Okay, let's go into Midjourney first. And the first thing we wanna do is to activate the new version 5. To do that, we have two options. The first one is to just type our prompt. So we start typing imagine. We write something like a woman with a red hat, and then double hyphen, and we type V space 5 and press enter. So like this we should get the version 5 activated. The second option, let's stop this quickly, we go into settings, press enter. So at the moment we are on Midjourney version 4, we just need to change it to Midjourney version 5. So we click and version 5 should be activated. Now, one of the issues we face with version 4, and honestly not just with Midjourney but also with all the other AI image generators, are the ends. These are usually malformed, they have more than 5 fingers, they are not well shaped, sometimes too big or too small. So let's have a look if this has improved in version 5. So I'm going to write something like ends of a woman, red nail polish, and then in the negative prompt I'm going to add ugly and malformed, and then I press generate. And this is what I get with version 5, and my first reaction is wow. Honestly, they look way, way better than version 4, and if we want to run the same prompt on version 4, what I got is this one, and honestly there is no comparison at all. So let's have a look at them together. We can see how version 5 not only has more beautiful ends and they are proportional, fingers are perfect, and obviously not for all of them, like we still have the number 3 here, which is still not perfect, but if we look at all the others, they are way more realistic, right? And if you look at version 4 compared, it's uncomparable simply. Also, we can see the resolution is way better. This is because the resolution of the first run has been doubled by Midjourney in version 5. Indeed, if we do the usual upscale, the image is not gonna have a higher resolution. So if we press U1 here you go, you will get the same picture with this exactly same resolution. And I feel also the light is way better, even if I haven't mentioned the light in the prompt, it's quite good. Okay, now I wanna see not just the hands, but I would like to see an entire figure. That's why I'm going to build another prompt where I wanna see a woman. And this is the prompt I'm going to run: a beautiful woman with a red hat, smoking a cigarette, wearing a white dress, intense eye, cinematic lighting, dark background, hyper-realistic, hyper-detailed, AK, and then in a negative prompt, we'll add malformed, double, low, and ugly. Let's see what comes out first with version 4. And this is my result. It looks good. The hands still are malformed, so it's not really following my negative prompt where I don't want malformed and ugly hands. I see also, I don't know, there is something wrong here with this woman, and I'm not completely sure about this picture. Probably once I generated them, I would have had to change them on Photoshop or maybe using another AI image generator like Stable Diffusion or DALL-E. So let's have a look now at version 5. Again, using exactly the same prompt. This is what I got. Must say that it looks way more realistic, it's more aligned to my prompt, Even if I wrote a very short prompt, and from the announcement they made, apparently with version 5 we should be writing longer and more detailed prompt for getting a better result, but honestly even using a very short one it seems quite good. And yeah, let's compare them again. Definitely more like a real photo, and the ends as well look way better also in this case. Would you agree with me? One thing I noticed though is the color. With version 4, I've always had this issue that when I mention more than one color, I get the whole picture colored of just one color, just one. So in this case, for example, we wrote that we wanted a red hat with a white dress, but it looks like that both in version 4 and in version 5, the model is giving more importance to white rather than red. Indeed, both in version 4 and version 5, we had just one picture which is aligned to what we want. And in the case of version 4, maybe not even one, because as you can see here, you have red on top, but it's white underneath. And here you have a white hat with a red flower. And in version 5, we have only this one where we have a red hat, even though there is something white. Don't know what they are. And yeah, you have a nice white dress. So it looks like the color is still an issue for version 5, and hopefully this will be addressed during the next months. Now let's rerun the same prompt, but let's add some tricks for this color to see if this can be addressed in other ways. One can be to add the plus between the color and the object. So if we go here, we will add, plus, and here again, plus, and let's see what happened. And this is the result. Now, still not there yet. I see now that here, number 3 has the red hat and has this white dress, and honestly, it looks pretty nice, but still all the other 3 images look not fully aligned to our prompt. Another trick we can use is to add more importance to the red hat, because honestly it looks like it's giving more importance to white in this case. So what we can do, I will leave the plus both here and here, and then after red hat I will add 2 columns and 2. This will give double importance to the red hat compared to the rest of the prompt. So let's run this again with version 5 and let's see what we get. And this is what we get. So we surely are giving more importance to red now. We have in all of the picture the red hat, but now for 2 pictures we have not anymore a white top, but we have a red one. Now, obviously this is not a major issue, but I think it's quite important. This is definitely something that needs to be improved by Midjourney. One thing I want to mention is that with this test version, you can also use different layouts. So you can generate not only squared pictures like it happened before with the test version of version 4, but you can also generate rectangular, just adding, you know, the dimension at the end of the prompt. And that's it for today. I hope this was useful. We compared version 4 to version 5. I have a look at landscape or these sort of things, but I have focused more on portraits and hands because these were more the downside of version 4. So we found that version 5 has improved a lot with respect to version 4. Images now really look like photos. They seems to be way more realistic. The issue related to hands, it seems to be addressed, maybe not fully addressed, but they are going in the right direction. There's still the problem related to colors. So if you found a solution to that, please let me know. It would be really appreciated. But that's it for today. Have a good rest of the day and see you at the next video. Bye.